Hi everybody, David Dilling from Markzware. Now I know there's a lot of you out there looking for a publisher for Mac, or you know, Microsoft publisher for the Macintosh. Well, it's just not going to happen. Well, at least not in that form. But what I'm going to show you today are a few tips on how you can get your publisher content usable on the Macintosh in comparable or much better even desktop publishing applications or processes. So let's go check it out right now. Now the first thing that you'll notice when you do a search for publisher for Mac is that there's a lot of people out there looking for it. There's, you know, 156 million results. You'll see various alternatives like Swift Publisher, iStudio Publisher, and there's a couple of other ones mentioned here, including, of course, Microsoft Office itself. And naturally, then we have even InDesign, which we'll get to in a moment, of course. So there are alternatives, a bunch of them. And now, how do you get your content from A to B, from publisher into another application on the Macintosh? Let me show you that here. Option one is an affordable tool we have called Pagezephyr. Very inexpensive. And what it will do is it will scan and index all of your Adobe InDesign, Quark Express, and Microsoft Publisher files. So what you get, and it's very easy to do, but I'm not going to show you that now, what you get is a listing of all of your content. And for instance, I can go into, let's say, this InDesign file here. And what we see is we get a drill down to actually see inside of the InDesign file without opening it. Now, it's only textual content, but that is often all that you need, or in any event, a big part of what you'll need. So you see here we got some kind of catalog, and it's just everything's in there. Text story by text story, or you can just get the entire thing here, like that. Publisher, I'm on a Macintosh here. You know, I would like to have publisher on the Mac. That's just not going to happen. How can I get my publisher content from my colleagues on Windows into something I can use on a Macintosh? Well, we saw there's alternatives, but how do we get it into that? Well, here we see a publisher file to start with. Click on that one. And then we can get all of the text. What you see is fully stylized text with color, stylization, italics, bold, font usage, you name it. It's all in the file like that. So it's really, really cool. But okay, well, we want to search our hard drive for all of our publisher files. Now I see all different stuff all mixed together. What you can do is you go up here and go search in and say document is, and then you'll get a choice here, and you choose, well, I'm only looking for my publisher files right now. And you have to drill back in, because these red folders mean that the content was not indexable or it's been moved. So I can delete those. And you do that up in your preferences, but no need to worry about that now. So now we go in, I see only the publisher files on our system. And you see when we click in, we get all of the content. Extremely handy to free up that content for use on our Macintosh. Let's just take a simple file for this. Let's just take all this content here. Now we can actually go in here and actually make edits. It's also possible. And we can now take this content and we go up here and say save. And we can say publisher for Mac content. We save it down to the desktop. And what we get there is, you can see here, this stylized RTF with all colors, fonts, and stylization used. Now, there's another neat thing. You can also search the content. So, for instance, if we want to search for all the words where we see the word model used, We click enter. We then can get here all the documents and text stories exactly, only which use the word model. And it even will highlight the text in yellow. So very, very interesting stuff. Take your RTF here. You can take this content and you can put it into iStudio Publisher, Swift Publisher, or even right into Word. I mean, right, we're in Word right now. I can just open this in Word and there we are. And some will say, well, that's fine for one project, but I also want the full layout. What can I do there? Well, for that, we have some other options. In Adobe InDesign CS6, we, Markzware, offer a plugin called Pub2ID. I should say we did offer a plugin, Pub2ID. I'll get to that in a moment. So you'll need to have InDesign. This is a more expensive option to get your publisher files editable and usable on a Macintosh, but it is a professional's option. And nowadays, Adobe on adobe.com has many options to rent the software for a month or a quarter or a year for a certain period of time at a very affordable price, so it's not so crazy. And up top in InDesign, if you buy Pub2ID or would have bought Pub2ID, you'll get Pub2ID, and you can hit Convert MS Publisher Document. And then you can go in there. You go in there and choose a file and click open. And Pub2ID converts everything right on over in InDesign with a click. Look at that. I mean, everything. Layout, colors, fonts. You got all the images that would have been used in there. Everything will be right there ready for you to use. You can then save this file out, and it's fully editable in InDesign. So that's Pub2ID. And basically, you're going to want to get that pretty quickly if you need to get Publisher into InDesign, because you'll see under our products listing, Pub2ID is no longer listed. I can still get you a buy link for Pub2ID for CS6, but we're stopping the product just because we haven't quite gotten enough sales on that product, although it has sold quite well. It works great. You know, it really does. If you need to get a publisher in InDesign, that's the way to do it. It's one click, as you saw, and it's done. If you click on store on Markzware.com, you will still see it listed here, and you'll get into the store. And I'll include these links down below so you can go in and actually still buy Pub2ID. And it works great, but buy it now because we're going to have to stop it. We have to concentrate on our main products, our flight check for pre-flighting and packaging, InDesign, even publisher files, Quark, and of course Q to ID, Quark to InDesign, ID to Q, InDesign to Quark, PDF to DTP, PDF to InDesign, or PDF to Quark. This is where demand's coming from, and as a small company, we have to concentrate on that. So get your Pub2ID today. And the same thing with Pagezephyr. I've shown you this today because Pagezephyr is also going away from here. But I'll get you the links down below to the Pagezephyr store where you'll be able to buy these products. They won't come with any warranty. We can't fix any bugs that might be in there. You know, these have been on the market for years, so they're pretty clean. And they do what they say on the tin. They work. They do what they claim to do. And both of them are very affordable products. And get them now if you need this sort of thing. Pagezephyr is extremely handy. I thought this would just sell hand over fist, but it just hasn't. It sold decently. And the people that use it love it to index their entire drive with all their content. Now, there is another option if you need to get Publisher for Mac. In other words, get your publisher files on your Mac. And that's the Markzware File Conversion Service. And there it's best that you email sales@markzware.com and we'll get you more information. Just tell us what kind of files you have, how many you have, how big they are, and we'll get you a quote. But in effect, it's $19 or euros per file per conversion. We will offer a bulk discount There you can see the email address, sales@markzware.com. We will offer a bulk discount if you send many at one time. And this conversion service has been very popular to do many things, you know, Quark to InDesign, PDF to InDesign, Publisher to InDesign. And with that note, you can get, you know, Publisher, as you just saw, we can get you RTF stylized text files, and we can get you downsave, you know, from higher versions of InDesign to lower versions, and all kind of other things. We also fix bad files to different service. But this is another option, you know, to help you get your Publisher files on a Mac or for a Mac. And this is the Markzware Dtp Conversion Service. It's a rather long link to this page. I'll put it there. But in effect, just email us on sales@markzware.com and tell us, you know, what you want to convert, what to what, how many you have, what size they are, and we'll get you a price. But generally, it's $19 or 19 euros per file. Only if the, you know, we've had someone send us a 4 gigabyte file, and, you know, that's, we're going to have to charge you a bit more for that. In any event, those are the options from Markzware. We do have an upcoming webinar. Check it out today on our homepage. Join us to give feedback on the products that you use from Markzware and to see what we have created with FlightCheck, PDF DTP, Q2ID, etc., and what we're working on for the future. Yeah, so cruise on over to our webpage today or email us on sales@markzware.com. We stand ready to assist. We find it terrible that we have to discontinue some products, but this is the reality of what will be happening. We stand here ready to serve you. We have the conversion service. We have the ability to still buy these discontinued products. Will be possible on our webpage. So we're not just going to leave you in the dark. So if you need Publisher for Mac or you need to get Publisher files into InDesign, then we stand ready to assist. Once again, David Dilling from Markzware, wishing you a fantastic day. Take care.